I have, by my migrations, avoided getting tied up in politics. I left Austria almost immediately. It was by accident, after I'd been called to sit in on the first governmental committee. I left England after 20 years, and it takes much longer there, just after the colonial office had begun to use me for public matters. I was never long enough in the United States to be used for public affairs. And of course in Germany, when I arrived as an old man, I think it was not alone a practical problem. So I'm almost unique among economists of some reputation of practically never having been tied up in government work. And I think it has been done me a lot of good. Government work corrupts. I have observed in some of my best friends who, as a result of the war, got tied up in government work. And they've ever since been statesmen rather than scholars.
One problem I understand, and I'm very sympathetic to that perspective. How does one translate, then, from the theoretical to the practical and political? Who is the intermediary? Is there a class of individual, then, that must lie between the intellectual and the politician? How do you bridge the gap?
Well, the economists whom we train to not become academics also do their job. That's all we are training, unfortunately, far too many, and certainly many more than ought to go into academic life. And I don't mind even people of first-class quality going into politics. All I'm saying is they no longer have the right approach to the purely abstract theoretical work. They are beginning to think about what is politically possible. While I have made it a principle never to ask that question, my aim is to make politically possible what in the present state of opinion is not politically possible.
A parallel I see to what you're saying is in the case of Dr. Milton Friedman, who spent a number of years of his work in the very theoretical without involvement in the political.
I think he is rather an exception.
Yes.
By not getting corrupted by it.
But he has now become more involved because he has many specific suggestions for political solutions, which are, and he would clearly admit to this, compromises of his own theory.
Well, personally, I think even he is, in one respect, an instance, he's invested so much in a particular scheme of monetary policy that he refuses to consider what I regard as the ultimate solution of the problem, the denationalization of money, privatization. That is so much beyond his scope of his aims that he rejects it outside. I think largely with the prohibition that's politically impractical anyhow. I believe he even sees the theoretical attraction, but he doesn't think it's worth pursuing because it's not practical politics. Mm-hmm.